Hello everyone, and welcome back to my channel. In this beginner's guide, I will take you through some of the basics of Microsoft's PowerPoint 365. PowerPoint has changed a lot through the years, but almost everything talked about in this tutorial should be applicable to previous versions and future versions. If you don't have PowerPoint yet, you can purchase it on Microsoft's website, and if you're a teacher or a student, you can download it for free on your school's website. Before we start, I want to mention that there are timestamps in the description, so you can go back to any part of the video at any time. Also, the video goes at a pretty fast pace. You can pause the video if it's needed. The first thing you see when you're opening PowerPoint is this interface. You want to click on the New button to create a new project. And here you'll see two categories: a blank presentation and templates. For this video, I will be using a blank presentation, but as you can see, there are a lot of already built templates that you can use. If you want to use a template but can't find one, you can also search for templates online using the search bar. PowerPoint's interface is built up out of four key elements. You have the ribbon, the tools, the slide, and the thumbnails. Using the ribbon, you can navigate through a lot of the options and tools that PowerPoint has to offer. You can navigate through ribbon by simply clicking on the titles and the tools. Then there's the slide, and this is what your audience will see when you're presenting. Here you can move, add and change objects to create a visual presentation. Then there's the thumbnails, and this is basically a menu of all slides that you've created. Your presentation will play in the order that these slides are organized. Another important function that I want to share beforehand is selecting. Selecting is important because it allows you to highlight a part of the slide that you want to edit. Selecting an object will cause all actions afterwards to be focused on the selected object until it's unselected. To select an object, hold your mouse and drag over the whole object. Once you've selected the object, all tools used will be applied to the selection. To unselect an object, simply click outside of the selection or press Escape on your keyboard. Now that you know the names and functions of all the elements, it's time to edit the slide. I will add a title and a subtitle. Click on the text boxes that are already on the slide, and now you can change the title and subtitle by simply typing on your keyboard. If you want to change the size, font, or color of the text, you want to go to Home in the ribbon and click on the text box. Under Font, you'll find all the tools to edit your text. If you've made a mistake, you can revert that mistake by clicking on the Undo button, which can be found in the left top corner, next to the Save button. Now, I'll show you how to add a picture to your PowerPoint presentation. You want to go to Insert in Ribbon and go to Picture, and here you can select from what source you want to import your picture. You'll see that the picture is probably on top of the text. You can move the picture by having your mouse on the picture, clicking and holding it, and dragging it to the side. Now, let's say that you've already made some progress making your PowerPoint presentation, but you actually want to use a template. You can still do that. You can go to Design in the ribbon, and here you'll find some templates that you saw at the beginning of the video. By clicking on the More button, you'll find even more templates. You can hold your mouse on a template to preview it in real time. I'll pick a template that looks good. In some of the newer versions of PowerPoint, you'll find the Design Ideas button under Designer. This will generate a slide using all added objects. This won't, however, change the appearance of the other slides in the PowerPoint presentation. It's time to create a second slide. To add a slide, you want to go to Home in the ribbon, and here you'll find the New Slide button. You can click on the slide with the green plus, but you can also click on the text with the arrow next to it. And when you're clicking on that, a menu will open with commonly used slide structures. I want to create an index slide with a picture, so I'll go for the option Content with Caption. Just like the first slide, you can add text by clicking on the text boxes that say click to add title or text. We'll also see a new type of box. You can use these boxes to add visual objects like pictures or videos. This way of adding a picture is different than the previous way of adding it, but it works as well. Instead of one picture, we'll add two pictures to this slide. We'll go to Insert in the ribbon, and here we edit our previous picture. As you can see, we can add more than just pictures. We can add videos, 3D models, even more text boxes and even charts. For now, I want to add another picture, and you can do that by clicking on Pictures and selecting the picture. If you've added the wrong picture, or you just don't like the look of the picture, a quick way to change it is by right-clicking the wrong picture and clicking on Change Picture. Here, you will be presented with options to change the picture. Now, let's add a third slide. Go back to Home in the ribbon. I want to make a slide to show two big pictures. For that, I'll go with the slide option, to content. This will open up a slide with a title and two boxes in which I can place pictures. You can add objects the same way as the previous slides. It's possible that both pictures aren't the same size. To make them the same size, you want to select them both by holding your mouse and dragging over both pictures. You then want to right-click on one of the pictures and go to Size and Positions. You want to make sure that both lock aspect ratio and relative to original picture size both don't have a check mark next to it. And now, you can enter your preferred height and width, which will be applied to both pictures. This is cool, but when you're presenting, you might not want both pictures to both show instantly. Instead of making two separate slides, we can use animations for that. You want to go to Animations in the ribbon, and next to all the animations, you want to click on the arrow with the stripe above it, and as you can see, there are four types of animations. You have entrance animations, emphasis animations, exit animations, and motion paths. You can use entrance animations to make an object appear. You can use emphasis animations to make an object do something to highlight it. You can use the exit animation to make an object disappear. And you can use motion paths to move an object around the slide. Let's say that you want the picture to appear when you click on the screen. You want to click on the picture and then add one of the entrance animations to it. You want to do that for both pictures. Now, you see that both pictures appear one after one. If you want both pictures to appear at the same time when you click on it, you want to open up the animation pane, which can be found under Advanced Animation. You'll see a menu with all the animations that are currently on the slide. You want to right-click the second animation and click on Start with Previous to have both pictures appear at the same time. And now it's time to add the final slide. Go back to Home in the ribbon and go for the option Section Header. Here you want to write the final statement for your presentation. If you don't like the design of your PowerPoint presentation, you can always go back to Design in the ribbon and choose a different design. This will redesign all your slides automatically, while skipping all the objects. Now, let's check the presentation. You can watch your presentation by going to Slideshow in the ribbon and clicking on From Beginning. And there you have it. I hope this video helped. My YouTube channel is focused on PowerPoint tutorials for beginners all the way to advanced. I make stuff like PowerPoint games and other interactive elements. Consider subscribing, and I will see you next time.